Hello friends, here we are again. I am going to show you how to install Windows Phone 8 custom ROM on your Samsung Galaxy SGT5360. So the first thing you need to do is to turn off your phone and take a backup of your phone through clockwork mode. I'll show it in another video. So here we are gonna begin with the Odin. So you have to download the zip file or the RAR file from the link I have provided in the description section. After extracting it, you'll get the three files as shown, as I have highlighted it over here. These three files, you'll get the following three files: a folder and two zip files. So the first thing you need to have is the three files and the Odin. So it's preferable to use the Odin version 1.85. So we'll do it. Right click on it and run as administrator for Windows 7 and just open it for Windows 8. So after you get this window, you need to enter your phone into the download mode. To enter your phone into a download mode, the three key combination, that is the volume down button, middle button and the power button. So we are gonna do that now. So the phone has entered into the download mode. So we'll press the volume up button to continue. There it is, the phone has entered into download mode. Then we are gonna connect the phone to the computer via USB port. So after connecting, you have just to keep the phone down, don't look at it. You will get a yellow mark over here. So unlike the video in which I showed you how to reinstall the stock firmware in your Android, you don't have to select the PID file. You just have to select the files named PDA. So for PDA, you will be selecting this file, PDA S5360. Then for phone, you are going to select modem S5360, and for CSC, this file, CSC X5360. There is no bootloader file in this formatting and no PID file. So, and also make sure that you do not click on the repartition checkbox. So we'll click on start to begin the procedure. You can see that the download has been started on the mobile. In case the USB cable is accidentally removed or your computer turns off power failure, so in this case your mobile is gonna be hard bricked, so it cannot be repaired with the procedure same as that of the soft brick as I showed it in the first video. But there is a different combination. You just have to connect your mobile to the computer via USB port, remove all the things in it, that is battery, SIM card and the memory card, and then just press the volume up and volume down button. So after that finishes, your phone is entered into the hard reset mode. And after that, you just have to do the same procedure as we did in the soft reset. So this is it, the phone has been wiped. So let it allow to start now. This will take a while because we have installed a custom version of Android in our mobile, which is unofficial. You can also overclock your Samsung Galaxy S5360 up to 1.2 GHz. That is, you can increase the base frequency of its processor from 832 MHz to 1.2 GHz or 900 MHz as well. The video links will be provided as soon as possible. So we'll allow the phone to start. This thing can take a while because, as I said earlier, this is an unofficial version of Android. So here it is, the phone has been started. So I'll just skip the procedure over here. So the only problem with this thing is that the language is something which I do not recognize. So here, just to change the language in your mobile after it finishes all everything. So we'll go inside menu, settings, locals and settings. Local and text, and here it is. Oh, this is Indonesian language. So we are gonna select English, United States, or any language that suits you. Here it is. So we have installed the custom OS. So then the next thing you have to do is to connect your phone in USB mode in order to copy the file. So we'll connect the phone in USB mode. Then after it connected, you will be copying the following two files: DODXDSLF full and monochromatic WP8 into a memory card. I'll show you. The files have already been copied. Here are the two files as it is. Do not extract it or do not do any changes to the files. And another file which you're gonna need is the clockwork mod, the same CWM blah blah dot zip. So after this, you'll be disconnecting the USB storage from your phone, removing the USB cable, and shutting down your phone. So the phone has been turned off. Next thing you have to do is to boot the phone in recovery mode. That is the 3 key combination of volume up button, the middle button and the power button. So we'll do that. Here it is, volume up button, middle button and the power button. And the phone will boot in recovery mode. After you see the Galaxy Y logo, you'll just remove your hands off the buttons, apply update from SD card, and you'll select CWM blah blah dot zip. So here it is, clockwork mod recovery. So in this thing, you do not require any wipe data or wipe cache partition. You just have to install zip from SD card, choose zip from SD card, and for the first time you are gonna select DODXDXLF full.zip. So you'll select this file, scroll down to yes and install it. As I always say, in order to root your phone or in order to install any custom OS to your phone, you must have a battery which is at least 80%, so that your phone doesn't get bricked when installing. So here it is, the installation has been completed. Now we'll reboot our phone. To go back, we'll use the power button and reboot the phone. this time as well the phone is gonna take a while to boot. I like to say that all the things which I am doing here does not belong to me. I just downloaded it from a random website, search it on Google, and I am just showing you how to do the things. I do not own any of the things here except for my mobile. That was lame. So the phone is about to boot now. So this is the last time you are gonna see the Samsung logo being shown on your mobile. The next time we are gonna do is the final step, and after that you'll be seeing, okay, I'll not disclose the error. So as always, after installing a custom OS or applying ZIP from SD card, it will take a lot to boot your phone. Just in case you have to remove the custom OS or to remove the Windows portability theme from your mobile, you will have to soft reset your phone or use the soft reset the phone as shown in my previous video or my first video. So here it is, the phone has been booted. So here it is, the phone is up and running now. So the next thing you are gonna do is again turn off the phone. And after turning off the phone, we are again going to enter the recovery mode, middle button, volume up button, and the power button. Update from SD card CWM blah blah dot zip. After entering the clockwork mode recovery, you will be selecting apply update install zip from SD card, then choose zip from SD card, and then you will be selecting monochromatic W8 5.7 something or whatever it is dot zip. So we'll select it with middle button and click on yes install. So it will be installing the phone, the Windows phone, into a mobile. This is it. So we'll go back and again reboot our phone for the last time. Again, for this moment, the phone is gonna take a while to boot. So we'll just wait for it. Here it is. Windows Phone 8 on your mobile. the Metro user interface, which Microsoft is boasting about, you're able to use it on your Samsung Galaxy Y. So the first boot, as always, is gonna take a while. So after you finish it, you'll be able to use your phone. It does not matter if your phone turns completely blank during the installation. It happens, and if you believe that the phone is not responding even after a long period of time, such as 10 to 15 minutes, then there may be a probability that the custom OS you have installed is fake or has some problems and you have bricked your phone. So you'll be again installing the custom OS, you'll be again installing the stock OS. So you have installed it, you'll get the message which launcher you have to use. So by default, you'll be selecting launcher WP8. Ta-da! Here it is, Windows Phone installed on your mobile. The start menu also has been changed, so you'll be accessing the settings as well. The settings also has been changed, about phone, and you'll be seeing Windows Phone 7.5 Mango version that shows the color of your Windows Phone, that is the Mango. So this is it. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you enjoy using Windows 8. Bye bye.